Okay, I think Umne sir, we should start, and because the students will coming up right now, there are 40 plus students have already joined, and student will come up accordingly.
Okay,
so
fine.
I think we should start with the lecture. Okay. Before starting the lecture, I would like to thank Dr. Pitambar Umne ji, head of the department, Dharampet Science College, associate professor there, and a long time friend of mine. And with my request, he has joined us in the occasion of World Environmental Day on 5th of June today. I'm very thankful to you, sir, that on a very short notice, you have joined for our this guest lecture. We also have with us our beloved HOD, Dr. C.C. Handa, sir, with us. I request Handa, sir, to welcome Umne, sir, and just guide us on this occasion.
The guest of today's program, the speaker on the very, very important topic, world environment. Let it be world environment, any environment. Mr. Pitambar, the Dr. Pankaj Gajbiye, the faculty in charge who has arranged this program, all the faculties who have joined for the program, and the students. It is indeed a proud privilege. I wish those who have joined the program may not join this program just as a part of activity to be accomplished or to join it. Try to understand. We have been seeing COVID all those years, and we have now by now understood due to COVID pandemic situation that the most important is environment. Even what we have seen is there are two, three major terms which I think the honorable speaker would discuss. Environment, preserving the environment, sustainable development, and sustainable environment. And whatever we are doing, we need to understand it is not for us to use. It is as good as you have something available with you, maybe as a nature. You are not expected to consume, use, or spoil it, and not to leave it for the generation to come. Sustainable, I mean, or the term sustainability now has taken a part in everything. Even in engineering, we talk about sustainable material, sustainable technologies, sustainable applications. The purpose means sustainability, the basic meaning of sustainable is whatever you are having today, you are just not a consumer of it. You have a bigger responsibility of saving that for the next generation. May it be the natural resources, may it be the nature, or whatever it is. The plastic, ban of plastic is a part of conservation of nature. Because plastic is not sustainable. I mean, plastic would spoil the environmental chain. We have seen the government of Maharashtra has banned all the plastic, and it is back again in the market. I enjoy this because it is, my friends, it is not only as somebody asking you. This would not happen unless everybody of us understand the importance of nature, importance of the eco-cycle, importance of conservation of water, air, nature, plant, tree, forest, everything. I was deeply impressed by my wife, because when it was a plastic ban, and whenever we go out, whosoever would give her maybe a vegetable vendor or a grocery vendor, whenever he would give her a plastic, she said, no, I have my bag, I don't want to use it. Aur wo usi ko gyan pila deti ki jab sarkar ne band kar diya hai na, आप लोग प्लास्टिक बंद क्यों नहीं कर देते थैलियां लाने के लिए. एंड आई गेट इम्प्रेस्ड. आई सेड नोबडी बीइंग अ हाउसवाइफ, नोबडी आस्क हर एज अ ट्रेनिंग कि यू नीड टू सेव एंड सेव योर नेचर, यू नीड टू कंजर्व नेचर. बट शी एज एन इंडिविजुअल हैज अंडरस्टूड द इंपॉर्टेंस दैट आई डोंट हैव टू सस्टेन लॉट ऑफ गुड थिंग्स. लाइक फर्स्ट टाइम वी हैव अंडरस्टूड द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. Have you ever known that the air we carry contains oxygen and the oxygen we consume would go to crores and crores of rupees for the lifespan.
I have an appeal to Gajbir sir.
Yes.
आपके साथ एक्सपर्ट है, आपके साथ स्टूडेंट की टीम है, आपके साथ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग स्टूडेंट एसोसिएशन मेसा है, ऐसे कुछ इवेंट और एक्टिविटी कीजिए जहां 100% स्टूडेंट इन्वॉल्व हो जाए इन कंजर्वेशन ऑफ नेचर, इन मेंटेनिंग द इको बैलेंस. ऐसी कोई एक्टिविटी लो, मे बी प्लांटेशन, मे बी एनीथिंग, मे बी क्रिएटिंग समथिंग आउट ऑफ इकोलॉजिकल वेस्ट. गिव अ प्रोजेक्ट, गिव अ एक्टिविटी, गिव अ पोस्टर कॉम्पिटिशन. जब 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 ये विद्यार्थी उस एक्टिविटी में पार्टिसिपेट करेंगे, जब जब वो उस इवेंट के पार्ट हो गए, उनको हमको सिखाना नहीं पड़ेगा. दे वुड बी एम्बेसडर, दे वुड बी क्रूसेड, दे वुड बी कैरियर ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट. द नेचर इज मोर इंपॉर्टेंट देन एनीथिंग इन द वर्ल्ड, एनीथिंग इन लाइफ. नेचर से बड़ी इंपॉर्टेंट कमोडिटी कोई नहीं. और जब ये बात हम उनको सिखा पाएंगे, जस्ट नॉट बाय लेक्चर्स बट पार्टिसिपेटिव लर्निंग, एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग, probably we would be able to make our mission of save nature and today's important day. I wish this program a great success. I would sincerely thank the chief guest for coming down. I know this is a charity. आपका भाषण हम समझते हैं, आप अपना समय दे रहे हैं दोपहर के 3:30 के बाद. लगता कोरोना में ये नींद का समय हो गया है और फिर भी आप आके विद्यार्थियों को नेचर के बारे में, एनवायरमेंट के बारे में बता रहे. मैं आपका आपका आभारी हूं और आपको साधुवाद देता हूं कि आप इतने अच्छे मिशन में. बहुत अच्छा है कि यू आर ए पार्ट ऑफ दैट सिस्टम. थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू पंकज फॉर होस्टिंग अ इवेंट. यू कैन कंटिन्यू.
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर गाइडेंस. एंड अभी मैं पढ़ रहा था सुबह आज पेपर में, क्योंकि आज पर्यावरण दिन है, तो ये कहा गया कि हर हम 3 सेकंड में एक फुटबॉल मैच का जो मैदान होता है उसके 3 गुना जमीन को हम बंजर करते जा रहे हैं. और इस स्पीड से अगर हम लोग जाएंगे तो शायद हमारी आने वाली नस्लें, हमारी आने वाली पीढ़ियां हमको माफ नहीं कर पाएगी. और इसी को ध्यान रखते हुए हमारे करिकुलम में भी EVS सब्जेक्ट ऐड किया हुआ है और उसी के मद्देनजर आज का प्रोग्राम हमने ऑर्गेनाइज किया है. ऑर्गेनाइज जितने भी बच्चे अभी ज्वाइन हुए हैं उनको यही मेरी एक सूचना है कि मैंने चैट बॉक्स में आपको लिंक भेज रहा हूं और ये आपका अटेंडेंस है आज के प्रोग्राम के लिए. तो आप प्लीज यहां से जाने के पहले आप ये अटेंडेंस फॉर्म फिलअप कर देना ताकि आपने ये प्रोग्राम अटेंड किया इसकी इंफॉर्मेशन हमारे पास भी रहे. हमारे साथ काफ़ी अलग अलग फील्ड के लोग जुड़ रहे हैं, काफ़ी इंटरडिसिप्लिनरी बैचेस के लोग भी जुड़ रहे हैं और जुड़ते जा रहे हैं कंटिन्यूसली. तो मैं और ज़्यादा समय न लेते हुए पीतम्बर सर से रिक्वेस्ट करता हूँ कि वो अपना लेक्चर स्टार्ट करें. थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू पंकज. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम वेरी मच थैंकफुल टू द ऑर्गेनाइजिंग कमिटी of KDK College of Engineering Nagpur Department of Mechanical Engineering and Mechanical Engineering Student Association for giving me this opportunity to talk on occasion of the World Environment Day on the title that is Importance of Environmental Science in Education. Myself Dr. Pitambar Humne, founder Botany for You and working as associate professor and head department of botany, Dharampet MP Dev Memorial Science College, Nagpur. Let's share me the screen so that I can go with every point. So with hardly for 30 to 45 minutes, we will finish the complete talk, and also this will provide you a very good information, and that will be related with us only, and we are not saying anything technical. If there will be any technical difficulty, then immediately you can convey me so that I'll manage. Pankaj sir, are you able to see this screen?
Yes sir, very much.
No any problem, na?
No, no problem sir.
So welcome my dear students in today's session on occasion of World Environment Day. First of all, whenever we are talking or listening the different news in the newspaper for the protection of environment, for the conservation of environment, then biodiversity, conservation of biodiversity, and as Handa sir said, sustainable development. Actually, we are only reading the news, we are reading the syllabi, facing the examination and scoring the marks. But whenever I am talking with my student during my teaching, then I always tell my student that what is the meaning of education. So first of all, there is a necessity to understand the meaning of education. So according to me, the education is nothing but the percolation of the knowledge from one generation to the another. Means whatever is given in the form of the information to us, in the form of the education, that is nothing but the knowledge, and this knowledge is given to us so that we can percolate that knowledge to the next generation. And hence, it is our moral responsibility that whatever we are learning in this world, we should transfer this information to the upcoming generation, and that is the main motto of the human race. Because we are not living only for us, but we are living for the sustainable development for the upcoming generations. You are very much well known about the different discoveries, as you are the science students, that the many scientists wasted or spent their complete life behind the single invention. So what they are getting? They are getting only the name, but the millions of peoples are getting benefited by such type of the inventions in the world. And because of this, we can say that whenever we are doing anything, it is our moral responsibility to implement that things in our routine day-to-day life, in our attitude and in our behavior. So today we will see why there is a necessity of such type of the environment education in the colleges, and what are actually the importance of such type of the education, and why the government has made this subject compulsory to each and every graduate students. So first of all, we will see here what is environment and environmental science. So if you see the literal definition of the environment, it is all the living and non-living factors affecting the organisms and ultimately determining its form and survival is known as the environment. Simply, we can say that the everything that is living and the non-living which is present around us, that is nothing but the environment. And even we are also the part of the environment. In other words, we can say that all the external factors influencing the life and activities of the plants, animals and the human beings. We are facing this corona pandemic and very well known about the effects of corona on the human race, and that is again one of the part of the environment. Then all the things, that is objects, means which are present around us in the form of air, in the form of water, in the form of soil, etc. In addition to that, here there are the circumstances which are present around us, and that are nothing but the different activities which are carried out by the human beings during the course of the development, during the course of the modernization, during the course of the some certain evolution or the changes in this ecosystem. Ecosystem is nothing but the study of living and the non-living things at a particular area and at a particular time. So that is nothing but the environment. So all the activities which are carried out by the human beings, that are comes under the circumstances. So such type of the studies, that is nothing but the environmental science. So then how the environmental science is related with us? Whenever we are talking why we are studying the environmental science, why the environmental studies is made compulsory to the student of engineering, student of science, or the student of the medical, etc. So this is because the environmental science is very much related to us at every step of the life. If you see the basic needs of us, that the basic need, the food, shelter, clothes, that is the roti, kapda and makan. So everything that we are getting in the form of the food, right from the pizza, chapati, rice and etc. So everything comes from the process that is known as the photosynthesis. And till today, we don't have any such type of the invention or such type of the any technology that has the ability to produce the food material, or simply we can say that the carbohydrate. So such type of the system is not still there in the universe, and hence every food that we are getting that comes from the plant, that is nothing but the environment, that is the living part of the environment. Even the cloths and our shelter, so everything that we are getting from the environment, and hence there is necessity to care, take care of this environment. Then the different natural resources, that is the water and the oxygen, and now the corona pandemic shows the importance of the oxygen. Whatever you are feeling, you are taking, and that is nothing but the air, but our body is absorbing the oxygen out of that air. And if this air is polluted at that time, number of pollutant will enter in our body, and hence the good quality air containing the highest amount of the oxygen is necessary for the healthy life. If you are present outside the city for 8 days in a such a condition where there is a good environmental or the healthy environmental condition, and if you enter in the city, then immediately you feel the breathing problems. So this is because of what? Because in the cities, the type of the air which is present that contain the maximum amount of the carbon dioxide. And this is because of what? Because of the man's activity or the different things that we are using here. In addition to that, the minerals, coal, fuel, petrol, diesel, etc. that we are getting from the environment. Then how we are related with that? That is the air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, agriculture pollution, thermal pollution, noise pollution and radiation pollution. And everything that is related to the human being with respect to the health, we will see in the upcoming slides also. So in this way, everything that is responsible for the pollution means that is nothing but to change or the alteration of the environment that is completely related to the health of the human beings. And that should be the priority of the human beings, to take care of the health and hence take care of the environment. Then the different natural calamities which are from the environment, that is the tsunami, tornadoes, then cyclones, earthquake, volcanoes, wildlife, then landslides and the fires. So etc. These are also related to us, and which are the different activities from the environment. In addition to that, the waste management, that is the liquid in the form of the liquid that is from the different companies, even from the household. Then solid waste. And nowadays, due to the modernization, inventions and use of the different electronics, there is a creation of the new problems of the e-waste also. And all these things are responsible for the change of the environment which is present around us. So that day by day, there is an alteration in the different conditions of the environment. And because of that, there is a necessity to do the critical study of the subject, so that we can solve these problems and we may not face these problems in the future, as well as the future generation may not have such type of the problems. Then how these different alterations or the change in the environmental condition are related with us with respect to the health. So if you see simply the air pollution, and only the air pollution is responsible for the different diseases or the disorders in the human beings, like the asthma, lung cancer, leukemia, chronic obstructive pulmonary diseases, then pneumonia, birth and the immune system defects, cardiovascular diseases and the premature death also. Then if you see the water pollution, then water pollution is responsible also for the creation of the many diseases like the typhoid, then giardiasis, amebiasis, ascaris, hookworms, gastroenteritis, then diarrhea, encephalitis, stomach cramp and the axe, vomiting, hepatitis and respiratory infections. So these are just only from the two categories. You can think now how much problems we are facing because of the change in the different environmental condition by the man's activity, which are responsible to alter the different set of the conditions in the environment. And on a global level, there is some other problems like the global warming. That is, there is an continuously increase in the temperature of the earth day by day. And that is very much fatal for the future. Every time we are seeing the news that the Himalaya is getting melted, there is an increase in the level of the oceans. So these are the different effects of the global warming. Then acid rain, which is one of the factor of the air pollution. Then formation of the smogs, the cities like the Delhi facing the problems of the smog. Then the reproductive potential, which is very much important and related to us or related to each and every living organism. If you see this reproductive potential is nothing but the ability to reproduce. And this ability to reproduce is being decreases day by day due to the air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, agriculture pollution, radiation pollution, thermal pollution, noise pollution, etc. Because everything is adversely affect on every living organism, that may the plants, that may the animal, or that may the human beings also. And hence, if there is an adverse effect on the reproductive potential of the organism, automatically the population of the organism will decrease in the future just only because of the pollution in the environment. And hence, there is a necessity to take care of this environment for the future sustainable development of the human race as well as the other living organisms. Then why environmental education is important, or why environmental science education is important? If you see the Albert Einstein, he rightly said that look deep into nature and then you will understand everything better, because there is a necessity to have the real observation in the nature so that we can understand everything in the nature or around us. There is no better way to build a global responsible citizen than imbibing the green living. We are just talking that there is necessity of the conservation of the water, conservation of the environment, conservation of the trees, but instead of there are the need of the necessities or the different policies which are responsible for the green living. So values in the children's to follow and eco-friendly lifestyles. So right from the lower classes, there is a need to inculcate, need to percolate such type of the attitude among the student, so that automatically the eco-friendly lifestyle will be evolved. Through this article, I would like to reach you, to educator around the world, to start taking the necessary step for the brighter tomorrow. So what are you going to do next to save the planet? Then only we will be able to save the planet Earth. Otherwise, we will have the many dangers from the same environment where we are living. Then why environmental science education and what is its important? So if you have the question that why environmental education to the students of the technology, but basically I'll say that the technology is a very much important discipline in the science, which can improve or add the very much good skills or innovative skills for the conservation of the environment. And hence, I even appeal the students of the engineering that you should try to find out the solutions for the conservation of the environment, so that in future we will have the healthy environment for us also and upcoming generations also, that is for the sustainable development. So the environmental education is to bring a change in behavior. This is very much important. As earlier Handa sir said, that my wife is providing the lecture to the persons who are using the polythene. Actually, this is the example of the behavior. Means it should be inbuilt inside us in our behavior, so that only we can able to conserve the environment. So there is a necessity to introduce this environment or the consciousness about the environment in the behavior of every citizen. Then to bring out the innate tendencies of an individual. Whenever we are talking about the innate tendencies, then we can say that the by birth activities. So when it is possible, when we will be taught even in the childhood, even from the mother and the father, that is from the parents. And why there is a need of the environment, then only it is possible that we will be the every individual who will raise the hand for the conservation of the environment. Then channelize the tendencies in a desired manner. No doubt, even the tribal people having the good knowledge about the conservation of the environment or the forest. But even at the same time, there is a necessity to channelize this behavior or these tendencies towards the environment in a desired manner, and that we are trying to do through this lecture. Because there is necessity to provide the correct information to the student or the every stakeholder who is related to the environment. And if we are talking about the environment, no doubt every living organism on the planet is related to the environment. Then to bring change in behavior for the environment protection. Whenever we are talking about the protection of the environment, on one hand we are delivering the lectures, we are talking about the protection, but actually our own participation is nil. So such a type of the thing should be avoided. Our behavior should be in a such a way that environment should be protected consistently, so that we can get the healthy environment in the future. Then to make each child as a agent for the environment protection. See what it said, each child as an agent for the protection of the environment, so that there will not be the any need of such a type of the awareness programs to be organized for the conservation of the environment. And hence there is a necessity to inculcate such type of the consciousness among the students. Then change in behavior to protect and conserve the environment. Whenever we are talking about the behavior with respect to the general people, with respect to the system, with respect to the politics and the different policies. So all these things should have a such a type of the behavior which should be the environment friendly. Because on the one hand, we are clearing the forest, we are clearing the trees, and on other hand, we are raising the hand for the protection. If you see the newspapers in last 1 week, you will find that there are 4,500 trees in the Ajni, and the NMC has given the permission to cut all these trees. Now the question remains same, which type of the development we are expecting in the future? Because how much time they have taken to grow 4,500 trees. So such a type of the behavior need to change in the future. We may not compromise at any step where there is a harm to the environment during the development. So our development should be in such a way that it may not harm at all even the single person to the environment, and then only it will be a sustainable development in the future. Then to produce the environment literate citizens. Actually, the environment information is with everyone, but the literate citizens with respect to that of the environment is nothing but that consciousness, that behavior that attitude towards the conservation of the environment, and that is reality towards the literacy among the citizens with respect to the environment, and that is very much essential in the upcoming future. Then what are the components of the environmental education? So if we see the components of the environmental education, that should be in the syllabi of the UG classes as per the compulsory subject, and that is the awareness and the sensitivity to the environment and environmental challenges, so that we will be able to participate individually in the solving different challenges or in facing the different challenges for the environment. Then the knowledge and understanding of the environment and environmental challenges. So we must have the correct knowledge of the environment, and hence the subject is introduced to the UG level in all the disciplines. And even there is a need to understand this cause of the environment. Then our attitude of the concern for the environment and motivation to improve or maintain environmental quality, and this is very important, because whenever we are talking about the environment, everywhere there will be the presence of the environment, but the quality of the environment we are losing. If you compare the environment before 50 years or before 100 years, now there is a lot of pollution among these years. So it means that there is an adverse effect on the quality of the environment with respect to the development, and hence there is a necessity to introduce such a type of the attitude among the common people, means everyone, including the students who are the growing citizens, to participate in every activity that is responsible for the conservation of the environment. Then the skills to identify and help to resolve the environmental challenges, and you should focus on this one as a student of technology, because whenever we are talking about the skills or the techniques, it is a part of the engineering, so that you can develop such type of the technique which are responsible to reduce the pollution, to increase the oxygen, so that it will be beneficial for the human race in the future. So there is a need of such type of the skills that should be responsible for the conservation of the environment. And the most important, that is the participation in activities that leads to the resolution of the environmental challenges. Every time, whenever any movement is going on, we have the tendency that it is not related with us. But whenever we are talking about the environment, then environment is related to each and everyone or every individual, that may the plant, that may the animal, or that may the human being. And hence there is need to participate in the every activity, so that we can take part in the conservation of the environment. And all these things should be a component of the environment education at every level of the education. Then what will be the benefits of the environmental education? First one, that learn how to use the resources sustainably. So first of all, you should remember that sustainably or the sustainability. Say for example, if we will have now the certain available crude oil, or we can say that the coal, if in the same speed the coal is taken off from the earth, this is not a renewable energy source, and hence it will be completely degenerate or vanish from the earth if continuously used. And so that the upcoming generations, after the 100 or the 1000 of years, they will only read that there was a coal inside the earth, because at that time there will not be the presence of such type of the resource. Even if you see the tiger or the stories of the tiger, you will find that after the 100 or 200 or the 500 years, the people will be able to know the tiger only in the pictures, because a very high speed we are losing the tigers from the world. No doubt it is also a part of the environment, because for the conservation of the environment even there is need of the saving this tiger. When always we are listening or we are seeing the news or the different things that there is necessity to save the tiger. Why there is this need to save the tiger? Because it is the topmost carnivore and which is responsible to control the number of other herbivorous organisms. So this chain is also equally important for the conservation and maintenance of the healthy environment and the ecology or the ecosystem. Then create awareness about preserving the environment. So we will be very much aware about the preservation of the environment if such type of the education will be introduced. Then to participate in the mass movement to protect the nature, when we will have the correct information, the knowledge, the behavior and the attitude, then automatically our participation in the mass movement will be increased. Then foster a healthy learning environment. This leads to the good environment in the upcoming future, or we can say that the healthy environment. Then pursue a full-time career in the environment studies. Even it is possible as a student, you can make your career in the environment. There are the more than 80 research institutes in India on the environment and even on a global level, so that we can also create our career or develop our career in the environment also. So this will be the different benefits to the student because of the environmental education. Then the strategies for the eco-friendly living. If we want to develop, we want to generate the eco-friendly living, then what should be the criteria for it? So the if we see the design, that is the R&D product planning and design activities with consideration for the synergy between the comfort and the eco-friendliness. As I told you earlier, that the NMC has given the permission to cut the 4,500 trees. So this is the development by losing the environment. So we should have the such a type of the R&D product or the planning or the design activities that is responsible for the eco-friendliness living of the human beings. So such type of the designing of the activities and the planning should be there. Then whenever we are procuring or getting or taking the anything from the environment, then the procurement of the materials and the parts with less load on the environment. So it must have the limitation. It may not that we have the need of the wood and we are cutting the complete forest, so that will not be the way of taking or procuring the wood from the forest. So such a type of the system of the procurement should be in a such a way that will not burden or that will not create the pressure on the environment. Then the manufacture, that the reduction of the environmental load resulting from the production activities and prevention of the environmental pollution. Nowadays we are facing these problems everywhere because of the development of the industries. And so whenever we are talking about such type of the industry which are responsible for the emission of the air pollutants in the nature, that becomes now unfit to the inhabitants which are living around that industry. And hence the coexistence with the local communities is not possible in such type of the areas. And hence our manufacture should be in a such a way that so that the coexistence with the local people should be possible. And hence it will not harm to the different environmental conditions. Then sales, distribution and installation, that is the reduction of environmental load during the cells distribution and installation. So even you know, for the shortest route, we are cutting the forest, cutting the trees for making the roads through the forest. This is actually the wrong process, that we are disturbing the wildlife also. So there is necessity to think over, because the many animals even are killing in the road accidents. And I am in an opinion that the roads should be in only overbridge pattern in the wildlife sanctuaries or in the forest, so that even as a component of environment, we can save the wild animals also. So such type of the system of the distribution of the cells or the installation should be there in the development. Then the utilization, that is the reduction of the carbon dioxide emission and in the amount of the water used during the product use. Now every time we are facing the problems, and that is the temperature, and second one is a water. Day by day we are losing the quantity of drinking water available with us. At the same time, every year there is an increase in the temperature around the earth, and both are very much harmful to the every living organism, and hence there is a necessity to reduce the carbon dioxide emission so that automatically we can maintain the temperature. If we can maintain the temperature, again it will be helpful for the conservation of the water also. So in this way, the environment is related with each and everything which is present around us. Then disposal recycling, that is the promotion of resources recycling for the collection, recycling, etc. for the used product. Even there is a necessity, if you see the today's newspaper, you will find that from single in the city of Nagpur, there is a 7 ton of plastic is released. You can just think over this, how much wastage in the form of the plastic in the single city, though there is a ban on the plastic. Means how much we are conscious about the environmental condition, how much we are careful about the environment conservation, that indicates this figure. And hence there is a necessity to have the disposal and the recycling system, and that should be the eco-friendly. And in this way, if at every step if we maintain the eco-friendly living, automatically we will help in the conservation of the environment. And the major environment movements from India that has been happened earlier, that the first one, that is the Bishnoi movement, where this is an image from the Rajasthan of the Bishnoi people. At that time the king was trying to cut the trees, and at the same time the some sacred trees were cut by the king, and hence the Bishnoi people try to save such type of the trees in the Rajasthan. More than 360 people were died during this movement. But later on, the king, when come to know that the peoples are interested to save this tree, later on he stopped this cutting the trees, and now that his name is also given to the area, that is a Bishnoi. Then second one, that is the Chipko movement, who was carried out in the Uttarakhand under the leadership of Sundarlal Bahuguna, who died recently. And Chipko movement means hug the trees. So that was also carried out in the similar manner to save the forest in Uttarakhand. Then Save Silent Valley movement in the Kerala, when there was an initiation of the hydroelectric power, the government was in a intention to cut the trees in that valley, but the peoples from the Kerala tried to make the movement against it, and later on the government take back the decision. And now there is a sanctuary in the Kerala at that same time. Then Jangal Bachao Andolan, which was also headed by the Sundarlal Bahuguna in the Bihar, later on from the Jharkhand and the Orissa. So this is also one of the movement of the common people in conservation of the forest. Then Apiko movement of the Karnataka, which is the same to that of the Chipko movement of the Uttarakhand. And the many peoples were on the road for the conservation of the forest, for the protection of the forest during the Apiko movement. Then the very well known, that is the Narmada Bachao Andolan for the Narmada, which passes through the Gujarat, MP and the Maharashtra. So that the government was in an intention to build this dam, that is the Sardar Sarovar Dam, having the 130 meter of the height. And it was very much harmful to the peoples inhabiting nearby that Narmada, as well as the plant population. Later on, this case was given to the Supreme Court, and this height was reduced to the 90 meter. And this was the victory of the Narmada Bachao Andolan. Then again, the Tehri Dam clan conflict of the Uttarakhand, that is also the similar type of the stories. This means that here there is an involvement of the common people along with their leaders in the conservation of the environment. My question is, why there is a necessity of such type of the movement by the common people for the conservation of the environment? Means the common people need the environment, and the government is not. There is a necessity to think over such type of the policies which are related to that of the environment, because this environment is the only source of everything, like the food and the health. And hence there is a necessity to have such a type of the policies that should be the eco-friendly and related, or the applicable for the sustainable development. So the last one, that is the what should be the policies of the environmental education. The introduction of the environmental education from KG to PG for the innate attitude in the children or the citizen, so that there is no necessity to teach the students about the environment conservation. Then the subject studies must be practical and the project based, and it may not be merely for scoring the marks only. Then equal weightage to the environmental science as like to that of the other subject. Whenever we are talking about the environmental science, is one of the compulsory subject to the student of UG in all these things. So there should be the compulsory subject, but at the same time the equal weightage to the other subject line, and hence automatically the importance of the subject will increase in the future. Then there should be the defined syllabus for the UG and the PG curricula in the universities, so that the every student will learn that subject with respect to the focused condition of the environmental conservation. Then examination should be conducted by the university. This is a deliberately introduced point, because we are seeing that the colleges are organizing the examinations for the environmental science, and because of that the seriousness of the subject is going to decrease now. So it, which is one of the important factor. Then expertise in delivering the knowledge. Nowadays we are in the such a type of the era, the peoples who are sitting in any area of the universe can deliver the lectures, and so that such type of the expertise in the subject can be used by the college for delivering the good knowledge to the students in their institutes. Then implementation strategies must be the fruitful. Whenever we are talking about the implementation strategies, we are also the part and parcel of the implementation strategy. As a teacher, I should be the rebel, I should be the responsible person for the implementation of the environmental science education. And hence, the seriousness in delivering this knowledge about the environmental science should be as a responsibility by every stakeholders which is related to this education in the environment. And the last one, that is, the development may not harm, adversely affect the environment. So whenever we are talking about any type of the development, it may not harm or may not adversely affect the environment. And in this way, then only we will be able to conserve the environment for the sustainable living in the future. So once again, happy World Environment Day to you all. Thank you very much for providing this opportunity to me. Thanks a lot once again.
Okay, thank you so much, sir. This was a very valuable guidance for all of us. And I think students will not only have listened to you patiently, but also they will imbibe and they will rule out with every word which you have taught them today. And yes, sir, this is a very serious issue that we have, all human beings are going through. With the recent pandemic and the COVID situation, we have all seen that playing with the nature is very difficult and it will prove fatal to us for human beings in the coming years. And really thankful to you, sir. And see you the same cooperation from you in future. And thank you all my students and faculties who have joined this program, especially the EVS teacher. We have Satone Madam, Ramteke Madam, we have with us. And also I'm thankful to Admare sir, Anda sir, our HOD. And once again, I'm thankful to Pitambar sir for delivering such a wonderful guidance lecture for all of us. Thank you all. Thank you all for joining. Thank you very much.